future is now.
Hi, my name is Christian. We are now live on YouTube from the Medwix showroom. We are here in the Medwix headquarters in Dresden in Germany. And today we want to talk about a brand new product we are now introducing you guys in the next maybe half hour, 45 minutes. By the way, Sebastian is helping me again today with the slides, with the video technique, things like this. Thanks a lot, Sebastian, for your help. Without you, this would not be possible. So this was the schedule, or is the schedule from this week. So a few days ago, 2 days ago, we had the 2020 March update. This video is available on YouTube. So you just go to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/Medwix_team, and you can find this video on YouTube. Yesterday we did the Medwix Radar introduction. Also, this video is available on YouTube. Today it's all about a new hardware, and tomorrow, same time at 4 p.m., we are going to show you the new features of Medwix 5.3, plus I think a huge or huge Q&A session, so a large question and answer. So if you have already questions, I can see already questions for tomorrow from a guy. Join the training tomorrow, join the session tomorrow for the Medwix session tomorrow. So Medwix is known in the event and entertainment sector. Medwix is also known in the nightclub industry. So we are on the market now since 2005, which is 15 years now. We have with Medwix 15 years in the market. Our main market was and still is nightclubs, event entertainment. And here you see a picture from the Hakkasan nightclub. This nightclub is in Las Vegas. They are using a Medwix Ultimate system, over 200 universes of pixel mapping in the ceiling. Plus also you have the triangulars which are coming down, up and down. So you have movements, these triangular shapes. Also there, the colors are controlled by Medwix. Now this club is located in Mumbai, and also there a Medwix software is running in the ceiling. So you have Medwix 5 professional running in the ceiling and a lot of nebulas running in the ceiling. A beautiful nightclub design, Medwix runs there, no problems. I told you that we have also Medwix on stages. Well, we have Medwix on big stages in the past with Ultra Music Festival, for example, in Miami. Other stages also here, we see a stage. This is Ray Garvey, very popular here in Europe, European region. On the left side, you see a lighting operator and designer, lighting designer, Christian Glator, Rocket Chris. He's using a Hawk 4. And on the right side, he's using a Medwix system. He's using a Medwix 5 Professional as an extension to his console. So he's doing all the intelligent lights, the foggers, the hazers, things from his Hawk console. And at the same time, he's triggering cues in the Medwix software, pre-prepared cues. At the same time, see Medwix here as an extension to his console. On the right side, you see the concert, the stage. In the middle, you see Ray Garvey. You see the rings. All these rings are LED pixel tape, a lot of pixel tape. Also in the front row of the stage is a lot of pixel tape. So also here, live controlling of all the channels, of all the pixels on the rings and on the stage using the Medwix software. Another great example of the usage of Medwix products. Here we have a situation in Moscow. It's a winter garden, beautiful installation. Also here, this video, you will find this video on YouTube. Just search for Medwix Moscow winter garden. And here you go on YouTube. You will find this video. Beautiful installation from our partner in Moscow, Imlight. They helped us with this installation. Also here, Matrix software is running. A lot of interfaces from us, a lot of hardware devices running here live. Now, over the years, more and more we are, you know, our products were used also in the architectural environments. Here you see a beautiful hotel. Basically, it's a bar. You have a beautiful dynamic ceiling, lighting, intelligent lighting in the ceiling with pixels. And Matrix is running there and is controlling the whole ceiling. But these kind of clients don't want to have a computer running in their buildings. So we got a lot of requests over the last years that clients don't want to run computers in buildings like this. This building is in Turkey, a beautiful hotel. It's a 5-star hotel directly on the coast. And in this hotel is running 4 Matrix Plexus devices, 1 as a master and 3 as a slave. So here we have the first standalone application of a controller. So here's Matrix not running live. Here is a standalone application running from a Plexus. And over the years, over all the years, all the installations are becoming larger and larger and larger. So from year to year, the amount of pixels in all the architectural installations is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And with the Plexus, the output was quite limited. So you had 2 universes of output. If you have a master and another one as a slave, so you have 2 plus 2, means 4 universes. But again, for these kind of installations, for these kind amount of channels and universes, very limited. Today, I'm very happy to give you an introduction into a brand new product our software and hardware engineers have worked on for the last years. And this is a replacement and a better product than the Plexus was in the past. And I will start the video right now. Have fun watching the video.
The ultimate standalone controller for your lighting project. Introducing Matrix Aura. Lighting design has become an essential part of modern architecture. With installations becoming larger and more complex, requiring ever-increasing quantities of pixels and DMX channels, the control system needs to remain up to date while providing a simple and reliable solution, preventing you from wasting time in configuration and updates. Matrix is all about powerful yet simple control products for creative LED lighting. Our products are highly respected in event and entertainment industries, and we are seeing increasing numbers of stunning Matrix projects created in the architectural and urban lighting markets. That's why we wanted to bring our amazing live control capabilities into a compact standalone package. A playback unit that is incredibly reliable and incredibly easy to use. Matrix Aura. With its custom-made hardware and software, it's built to meet the different needs and requirements of today's lighting designs. Matrix Aura is designed for continuous 24/7 operation, 365 days a year. One compact, powerful, and energy-efficient device to replace expensive and bulky workstations with their need for regular maintenance, updates, and administration. Experience how incredibly fast your lighting design is implemented into Matrix Aura. Just press record and stream all the information needed via network into your device. Impressive Matrix installations worldwide prove that quality counts. Matrix Aura makes the integration simple. Just connect Matrix hardware products like Nebula, Stella, or Luna as reliable output devices while using Orion to create stunning interactive projects. Our most powerful standalone lighting controller, Matrix Aura.
So this video and all the information you can find on YouTube and at medrix.com, at our website. You go to medrix.com, top menu products, scroll down a little bit to Aura, and then you can click at the Aura. All the information about the beautiful product is on our website. Again, also the video. And so it's really designed for DIN rail applications. Like the Stellar and like the Nebula as well, you can also mount the Aura to the wall using a wall mount set. So it's also in the box. We will have two versions available for you from the Aura, a Medrix Aura 8 and a Medrix Aura 32. The numbers are staying for the amount of DMX universes for the output. So the Medrix Aura 8 can output 8 universes of data, and the Medrix Aura 32 can output up to 32 universes of data standalone. Now the question for today is, of course, how much is it, right? The price. As you know, Medrix products from the very beginning until today, from the software to the hardware, are very affordable. This was from the very beginning a goal of our company, of our products, having affordable products. And we want to do the same here exactly with these devices. So Medrix Aura 8, 8 universes, standalone, no computer necessary, no operating system, no headache. Is just €600 retail here in Europe. And the Aura 32 is just €1,200 retail here in Europe. The pricing is in some countries a little bit different. So US pricing, India pricing is a little bit different. Contact your local dealers, your local supplier, your local distributor for your pricing in your country. The product will be available in the third quarter of 2020. So third quarter of 2020. Of the device, 4 buttons. So these white are buttons, 4 pieces, brightness up and down. So if you click up, the brightness will go up and the brightness will go down if you click down, of course. Same for speed. So you can change the brightness and with pause, shift and skip. So if you press play, the show which is saved on an SD card will be played, pause will pause the show. If you press and hold shift and you press play at the same time, you have a record. Again, I repeat, you press shift, hold shift and press play to activate record. So if you do this, you can record any stream from the network. Then you have also a skip button. If you press skip, it moves a scene forward. Shift and hold shift, pressing the skip button additionally, will go a scene back. Very easy to understand. At the top, you have 2 network ports. Both are RJ45. The Aura supports 10, 100, and gigabit technology. The Aura will automatically detect if it's a 10, 100, or gigabit network called Auto MDI-X. In the middle, you see a slot for the SD card. Now, Medrix Aura supports SD cards, SDHC cards, and SDXC cards. And the maximum is 64 gigabyte of SDXC SD card. You can store hours and hours and hours of content on such an SD card. Again, on the left side, power connection. You can connect 5, 12, or 24 volts of power. You have a USB connection. The USB port is not for sending data. It's just for firmware updates and powering the device, not for sending the data. You have the SD card slot, and on the right side, you have the 2 network ports. These ports are designed for sending data to the device. Now, Medrix Aura is the advanced lighting control recorder and standalone playback unit for your installation. It has a standalone playback from SD card to ARTnet or streaming SEN. So you can decide you want to output ARTnet or streaming SEN. Depending on the Medrix Aura 8 or 32, You have 8 or 32 universes of output. You can live record. You can record any ARTnet or streaming ACN network stream and 2 VSD card. And this is super easy. It's just record, pressing record. And then, of course, if you want to playback, record and play, very easy to use. Matrix Aura is the central hub, means it's the centerpiece of your installations. Around the Aura, you can use Matrix Stellar, Matrix Nebula, or the Lunas as output devices. And because the Aura outputs industry standard ARTnet and streaming SEN, you can also use third-party ARTnet or streaming SEN devices. Matrix Aura supports time-controlled shows. So Aura has an internal clock. So you can say you want to see this effect at maybe at Wednesday at 11 a.m. in the morning. And also sunset and sunrise timers are supported based on your GPS location. So you can type in your GPS location into the Aura, and depending on your GPS location, you have sunset and sunrise timers to trigger the scenes on the SD card. Also, Aura supports master-slave synchronization like the Plexus did this in the past. So you can have synchronized shows more than 32 universes if you use one device, one Aura as a master, and the second one as a slave, for example. Both would be Aura 32. You had 64 universes. One as a master and one as a slave. You can add more slaves. So the limit is basically budget normally. So again, master slave and scalability. You can configure the device very easy using a web browser from your smartphone, from your tablet, or from a web browser like Firefox. Live control. A few moments ago, you saw the 8 buttons for changing the speed, changing the brightness, play, pause, shift, and skip the shows. Now these buttons you can press, and you can change the brightness live. Matrix Aura supports also remote controlling. So you can trigger Matrix Aura via HTTP, means from a website, for example, like again, from your phone, from a browser, from your tablet, and also ARTnet and streaming ACN is supported. So you can trigger Matrix Aura from your console, from a browser, from your smartphone, from your tablet. In combination with a Matrix Orion, you can even do interactive installations standalone. Matrix Orion is not the topic for today, but it's a device where you can connect sensors like wind, temperature sensor, motion sensors, and then these kind of actions are triggering the scenes which are stored on the Aura for immersive, interactive installations, no computer necessary. It's really, really nice. Aura top view again. And the Matrix Aura supports daisy chain. So you can connect up to 40 units of Matrix Aura 8 and up to 10 units of Matrix Aura 32 to each other. You have 2 network ports. You go from the computer to the first device, then from the second network port to the second device, third device, and so on. And if you do this, you can have installations up to 320 DMX universes, standalone, no computer, no operating system, nothing, no headache from the Aura. Same situation here, you have master and slave. So you go from the computer into the first device. The first one is the master. When you connect the second one, you can configure the second one as a slave and you can scale up your installation. And now I want to go and to show you how easy it is using Matrix software to record any Matrix effects to the device. I will give you 3 demos. Number one, I will record from the main desk, from a Matrix main desk to the device. Number two, I will show you how easy it is to create a cue list in the Matrix software, to record this cue list to the Aura. Number three, later during my talk, you will see that you can record also from a website any ArtNet or streaming SEN stream which is in the network using the website. And I start my demo now. So we can now see the Matrix software. And this is a beta version. This is Matrix version 5.3 beta right now, not public. I will talk about this update tomorrow more in detail. So these kind of recording functions you see now will be available in May, in a few weeks, starting from today. If you look at the Matrix user interface, you see a record button. And in the past, if you press the record button, it records the output in the middle to a file. And I can show you this. If I click right mouse on the record button, I can set up a duration. I click here duration, and I set up, I want to have a 10-second record. I press OK. If I now press record, the software will record the main screen, this output, to a file. And after 10 seconds, the software will ask me the location of the file. Here we go. Here is the records. I can name this to Christian, for example. Very creative. Christian. And I can save this. So you can use these records already also with your Matrix software with older generations in the video effect. So you click an empty storage place on the right side. You go to video effect, click open, and you search for the location of your record. Now this is the Christian record we did. I open this record, and here we go. You see on the right side, now the record from the main desk we recorded a few moments ago. Now if you do this, you can store all your Matrix effects into one recording. Imagine you have a very creative setup with a lot of layers, like 10 layers, and you press record. All these 10 layers will be merged into one file, and you can save this onto your computer. Now, in the next moment, you go to your video effect, open this record, and you have only one layer. So this technology, this recording technology, reduces CPU load a lot. Now we go back to the software. And I will show you how you can change this record from a file to another one. We go to menu preferences, options. In the options, you have recording. And here in the recording, again, this will be available with Matrix 5.3 very soon. You can decide you want to have a Matrix record, which I showed you a few seconds ago, or a record for a network record to the network. And here you can set up your frame time. And here you can set up your groups. So you can set up all groups or just one group. If I now press OK, this software has changed the recording function now to network record. So again, I click right. I check the duration, it's still 10 seconds. And if I now press record, the record will go to the Matrix Aura and the Aura will automatically start the record. And after 10 seconds, it will stop. So I press record now. We are changing to the other camera. We see the Matrix Aura is blinking red. And after 10 seconds, it stopped automatically. And we go back to the software, and I select the black scene for everything. So and right now, no content is playing in the middle, right? Everything is black. We go to the Aura again. And here we have a play button. I told you all you need to do is you press play. And here's your record, which we stored on the SD card. Now this record is now playing the whole time. After 10 seconds, the Aura will automatically fade to the first frame. So it's a beautiful image. You will see this if you look at the LEDs. From the last scene, again, you know, we see the LEDs. After 10 seconds, a beautiful fade from the end to the very beginning of the show. really nice, not a hard cut, it's beautiful fading. So this was the first record. I press stop here, again, shift, pause, stop, and I go to the software. In the software, the second option we have is the cue list. Here is the cue list. The cue list is right now empty, okay? So I can prepare some cues. Let's do this. We are creating some effects, like a radial effect, for example. This one, I cue this, and I create another one. Color scroll, like this. More beautiful. This is nice. I cue this, and another one. Flames, for example, also nice. And I cue this as well. So now in the cue list, you have three cues. Q1, 2, and 3. This is the three storage places we queued. In the duration, you can set up seconds. So you can say, for example, 5 seconds for 5 seconds, 5S for 5 seconds, 5M for 5 minutes, 5H for 5 hours. You can also combine. So you can say 5 hours, 4 minutes, 2 seconds, and enter. If I would record this, it would take way too long for today. So I will change this to 5 seconds, enter. The second one is 4 seconds, enter. And the third one is 6 seconds, enter. And I'm done with my cue list. All I need to do now is here, press record. And if I press record, the Matrix software will start, the aura will start the record. It's now in queue number 2. And it will change automatically to queue number 3, the fire. And after the third queue, it will automatically stop. See, stopped, recording done. We go back to the software. I will change the output, but you don't see any output right now running. Again, we're going back to the aura. If I now press play, it will play back the cue list we recorded. So you see now three cues in the beginning, cue number 2 and cue number 3. And after this, you will see, after the fire, you will see the recording from the main desk, the green one, which you see right now in the image, which was the first record from the main desk, from a Matrix main desk. So it fades automatically between the scenes. So I will show you now that you can configure the device from a website. And to do this, we go open the website. So all you need to do now is you type in the IP address of the Aura device into your browser, into your smartphone, tablet, or here it's a Firefox device. And you see this user interface. Here in the live control, you can play, pause, and do records. I will go into more into details soon. I will guide you through here in files. You see the files. We have 2 files. The first one was the main output, the main desk record. The second one is the queue. In playlist, you have the two entries. The first one was the main, the second one was this. Here you can change also the intensity. You can change parameters. You can say, I want to have just 50% of intensity. You can change also speed. And the fade times I told you a few moments ago, you can change here as well. In timer, now this is interesting. I told you that you can set up sunrise and sunset timers, and I will show you how this works. You press plus. We are creating now a new timer. We are setting up the timer and we're giving them a name. I call this sunrise. Okay. In time type, you have sunrise as an option. Type is daily, of course. So every day at sunrise, it will trigger. I press OK, and I press save, and it's automatically saved. So I have now my first timer. I press plus, create a second one, and I use sunset. OK. In type, I change lately, I leave it to daily and type here, I go to sunset and press OK and save. So now I've created two timers, one for sunset and one for sunrise. And in a few moments, you will see how I can easily change the GPS location here in the device. Now to record. Now in record, you can record from ArtNet or from streaming ACN. You can also turn off. So you can decide, this is an Aura 32. So you can record 32 universes by ArtNet or streaming ACN. In playback, you can do the records which are stored on the SD card. You can turn them off, output them by ArtNet, or output them all the effects by streaming ACN. You can decide you want to broadcast the information or unicast the information to a specific IP address. And here, full frame is a full package, is a DMX 512 full package, all and on yes or no. So you can decide if you want to send this here as well. In remote, I told you that you can remote control this by ArtNet and streaming SEN. So you can set up here the universe and star channel. Now, interesting is configuration. Here in the device config, you can give the Aura a name. You can change the IP address, the subnet mask. You have sync groups. So sync groups is very interesting. I told you that you have master-slave technology. So here you can set up master and slave. In start settings here, you have autoplay, last play scene, disabled, or first play scene. And I want to show you this, how this works. I press now disable, set. So when I now go to the Aura, it will not automatically start a show because we disabled this. So it's reading the SD card. Here you can see it's the green LED, it's reading the SD card, but not playing the show. I go back to the configuration page. Now in the configuration page, I click now last played scene. I press set, go back to the Aura. I remove the SD card again, and I insert the SD card. The device reads the SD card, and boom, it plays the show, right? So we go back to the configuration. In the configuration, you can also set up date and time, of course. So today is the 2nd of April, somewhere like 4 p.m. and 33 minutes. So we are now 33 minutes online. And interesting part also here at the bottom, I told you the location settings. So if you use sunrise and sunset timers, you want to have your local location. So here is a nice link. Click check location on Google. We will check the location right now. So this, by default, if you buy a Matrix Aura, the default configuration is our office. So here in Dresden, in Germany, we are on the far right corner of Germany, close to Czech Republic and Poland, and you can change this. So if you want to change the GPS location for your Aura, let's say we want to have this location for Moscow. We type in Moscow, Google Maps. Here is Moscow in Russia. I click here. And so all I need to do is I click here, select the numbers, copy. I go here into the Aura, paste. And I select this one, copy. And paste. I press set. Now we have this GPS location of Moscow. And if I now check the location on Google, you will see that we are somewhere in Moscow. So now we could use sunrise and sunset timers for Moscow, for London, for Mumbai, for Miami, whatever you want. All you need to have is Google, very easy, Google Maps, copy, paste to your Aura, and you can use sunrise and sunset timers. The last one I want to show you in the web configuration. Before I show you this, is device info, also interesting. So you can see it's a Mavericks Aura 32 we are using here right now. You see the IP address, you see a firmware, so the hardware developers last night worked very hard on a new firmware update for me for the presentation. So thank you, Sven, thank you, Thomas, and thank you, Sebastian Pinzer, for working hard last night on a new firmware, which is working very, very nice today. We have the hardware release, we have the input voltage, the temperature voltage. You see also the Ethernet to Ethernet ports. Again, the Aura automatically detects if you have 10, 100, or gigabit technology. You see the inserted SD cards and things like this. Now, in live control, back to live control, you have different options. So you have skip back, record, stop, play, pause, and skip forward. And I want to show you this record function. Before I do this, I press now stop. So if you go look at the Aura, the Aura is no more blinking, it's no more light up in the middle here with LED, show has stopped, no content, stop, we go back to the computer. Now, imagine you have an ArtNet or streaming SEN stream like this one, right? If you click now, go back to the camera, you see the stream right now. It's a red colored effect. This could be, the content could be from a media server, from a console like an Evolite, MA, Hog4. So it could be any content coming in the network by ArtNet or streaming SEN. Imagine you have NomadVix software running. All you need to do is here at the website, you press record. We are looking at the Aura. Now the Aura is recording live the network stream by ArtNet and streaming SEN. We go back to the software, to the configuration page. We press stop, back to the Aura, and we'll see record has stopped. I can now press play, and you will see it will play back the recording from the SD card. So again, this is the live record. After this, we have two additional scenes. So you will see the whole show here in the device. So this was my presentation of the Aura. I think, as you can see, recording from the Matrix software to the Aura is super easy. It was very complicated with a Plexus device. Now we make it way more easier to get the Matrix content onto the device. Super easy. Let's repeat, sunset, sunrise timers, timers, playlist, 32 universes, standalone. It's an amazing device. So I'm almost at the end of my presentation, and we are now in the Q&A section. I will wait some minutes because we have a delay because of his live stuff here, of his live stuff. So now it's the time to ask me any questions regarding the Aura, the queue list, the recording, SD card, standalone, master slave, whatever you want. Now is the right time to ask me any questions. Again, the device will be available at the third quarter later this year. We will inform all the dealers and distribution partners before it's public, so you can contact your local dealer in your country, call them for pricing, availability, things like this. You will find the dealer information and distributor information on Mavericks.com in the top menu. There's where to buy. And then you can select the countries and you have your local dealer. So we have one question from Ao Sholet. I think they are from China. Matrix training and training how to set up Matrix Connect Resolume. We have on Friday, tomorrow at 4 p.m., same time, a Matrix session 5.3. I can go into detail about this. You can connect any media server to Matrix. It's easy. How to do this? Tomorrow. I will answer this tomorrow. It's not a topic for today. Rob Kirby, Hello, Rob, to UK, to London, London, south of London. Can we start with a new product dance this time? You're so funny. My friend, I will send you a video later. I don't want to have this here on YouTube. Watch for my iMessage. We will do a dance with Sebastian, 2 meter distance each other, right? Okay. So, Hani Harioto. Hi, Christian. Hope all guys are well. Yes, we are doing all very good. The complete team is very healthy. Here in the Matrix headquarters is right now only Sebastian Weissmann, which is the chief software developer of the Matrix software, and me, nobody else right now. All the other guys are working from home, home office. So the hardware developers, the software developers, the marketing team, sales team are all working from home now. If you have questions regarding sales, technical questions, drop us an email. These guys, all these guys from home, can have access to the emails. They answer very, very fast. We have Skype, so you can contact us like before. It's no problem. We are doing very good here. Thank you for asking. New vision, technology, our friends from Taiwan. Greetings to Taiwan. Greetings to CS Ouyong from Taiwan. I want to order when it's available. Available third quarter 2020. And we are maybe giving away some samples before this date for you to test. So very likely you as an official Matrix distributor will get a device before anybody else for testing, reporting. We want to do this. I can't give you a date for this time today, but as you can see, the software is working very, very nice already. So it will be maybe in a few weeks. I will inform you, CS, by email, by Skype, as soon as we can ship one. Hani Harioto, Christian brother, please let me know if you are out of coffee beans. Yes, my friend. If you look at my Instagram, Hari Harioto is from Asia region, and he sent me a few, I think it was a year ago, he sent me 2 big packages of beautiful, amazing coffee, and I love it. I have here a professional coffee machine. All the guys in the office were loving the coffee. If you are able to still ship something, I would be very happy to get something for you, to get something from you. And if we can meet each other together at another trade show in the next month or something, I will bring some local coffee, really good coffee from Dresden, from Germany, to you to enjoy your coffee, because I know you like coffee as well. Claudio Gianfoni. Hi, Claudio. He's from Italy. I have more than 32 universes in my project. Does 1 hour record all the universe, or does it record only 32 universes? Good news for you. The best situation for you, Claudio, because you are using already Matrix software, the master slave stuff. You set up this in the Matrix software. All you need to do is you press just one record button. You have master and slave. The Matrix software and the Aura will do a synchronization above everything. One record. The master is recording 32 universes. A slave is recording 32 universes. If you have another slave, it's also recording 32 universes. If you use Matrix, it will be done automatically for you. Super easy to use. Joshua Carroll, my friend from United States, from Inner Circle Distribution. Joshua is doing sales and also support for Matrix in the United States. His question is it possible for the Aura user interface to be viewed like the HTTP remote without the Matrix PC running in standalone? So again, this is HTTP. You can start this website from your phone and you see all the controls from the device. So you don't need a Matrix PC running. So you open your phone, type in the IP address of a Matrix Aura. You see this web page, as you saw a few moments ago. You can stop, play, pause, change brightness, change speed, doing things like this, not a problem. You don't need a Matrix PC running. Question 8, Snido Davis. I hope I pronounced this right, sorry. Can I also set an interval? For example, 15 minutes between the scenes. Well, you have a queue list. So you can have an empty queue, like a big black queue, for example. If you insert a black queue, 15 minutes black queue, you have 15 minutes black between the scenes, which would be super easy to do this in this way. Or you set up each queue 15 minutes, depending on your style, what you want to achieve. So not a problem. You saw the recording from the queue list with date and time options. And I told you that you can set up H for hours, M for minutes, and S for seconds. It's not a problem. Rob Kirby again. Will the web interface be on Magix 5.3 also? Can the audio in trigger from Orion to change the speed of Aura output? This is two questions in one. Will the web interface be on Magix 5.3 also? I don't understand this, to be honest. The web interface comes from the Aura. In the Aura runs a web server. It serves the web page. No matter if you're using a smartphone, tablet, or PC, the Aura is transferring the web page to this smartphone, to your tablet. So you don't need a Magix 5.3 for this. And can the audio in trigger from Orion to change the speed of Aura output? The Orion is a device for input. You can connect the Orion to the Aura, and depending on the sensors you connect, like light sensors, motion sensors, buttons, things like this, you can trigger the scenes of a Magix Aura, or you can trigger the master, the brightness, you can do play, pause, or changing the speed. So it's a very creative tool, the combination of Orion and Aura with sensors, beautiful for standalone applications. Nicholas, oh God, the name, Chamalalamapai, sorry, oh, this one. Can I connect 10 Aura 32 with 40 Nebulas in same daisy chain? So 10 auras in a row is 320 universes. Additionally, 40 nebulas would be too much. Our recommendation would be a network switch. So you go from the computer to the first aura. Then you connect your 10 aura 32. So you have 320 universes standalone, and you're choosing a second line from your network switch to the first nebula, and then from the first nebula to all the other nebulas. This would be our recommendation. It could work, but from us, it's not recommended. Badru, lighting designer. Hello again. He was also here yesterday, and I think the day before as well. The question is, what is the maximum capacity of an SD card for Aura to record? We've tested until today, 64 gigabyte, works flawlessly. You can record hours and hours and hours of records. It depends on your frame rate. If you're recording with 33 frames, which is the default setting for Magix and the Aura, you can also record with more frames, like 50 frames, when the speed or the time you can record would be less. But again, it's hours and hours and hours of records, not a problem. Question 12, Chandon Kandalwal, sorry, pronunciation. Can we save scenes on SD card from computer and then insert it into Aura and at remote location? It would be helpful if the site is away from programmer's location. Really good question. If you want to see this, we make a demo. I show you this. So we go to the Aura device. I told you, if you look at the Aura, you press Shift and play to stop the show. You can remove the SD card from the Aura. So here's the SD card, and we are going now to the laptop. We are inserting the SD card to your laptop. We wait a second. Here we go. Here's your SD card. You see, by the way, here you have your three shows, three records. This was the main record, the queue list record, and the website record, some configurations. So what you can do is you can back up this one. So you can say copy. You go to your desktop. Then we have Aura records here. You can say a new folder, backup, enter. We can insert these files from the SD card, so now it's saved on the computer. So we go to the SD card. This is the SD card, and I delete all the files on the SD card. yes, I want to delete everything. The LVSD card is now empty. So you can go now to your desktop, to the Aura records, and I prepared already some backups for today for this question. So this is project number one. These files, it's just one record. I press copy, go to the SD card, paste, remove the SD card, and I go to my Aura. And again, I insert the SD card. And here we go. It's another show from your computer stored an SD card. It plays automatically because we set up the device where it shows and playback the last scene. So yes, this is a nice feature. You can prepare a lot of shows for all your clients. You can backup the shows. You can copy the SD cards, everything you can do. Chintan, another question, 13. Will we have an Aura with SBI output or DMX output directly from the Aura? It would eliminate the use of Nebula and Stellar for very small standalone applications. The question is no. We want to have one device, one unique device, where you have all your shows in your device, and you can decide you want to use DMX output when you go for Stellar. You want to have SBI output, you go for Nebula. And if you want to have even more output, like 32 universes, you can also decide I go for two Luna 16. So you are freely, you can free design if you want to use Nebula, Stellar, or things like this. So my question is no. The Aura is a recorder and playback device for any connected devices like the Stellar and Nebula. Question 14, Hugo Malian, can I remotely activate playback and scene change for multiple Aura remotely running separate scenes? Can I remotely activate playback and scene change for multiple Aura remotely running? Ah. So you can remotely control all the Auras. So let's say you have different groups. You saw you can use groups. Imagine you have a building, front side and back side of a building. Front side is group number one. So you're recording to group number one. At the front side of a building, you have one master, one slave. Both are in group one. Now at the back side of the building, you have also a master and a slave in group two. So these devices, all these four devices are in the same network. Now, when the master is changing a scene on the group number one, it changes automatically also for the slaves. All the slaves in scene in group number one would automatically follow, frame synced, and the same for group number two. And you can remotely activate the playback, of course, from a smartphone, from a tablet, from a computer. Yes, would be possible. Juan Santander Pineda, also a Matrix partner from us. I would like a Matrix control console hardware for illuminators. It is not enough to shoot from other console. We want to have control physically and not through a touch screen or MIDI controls. It's nothing today to do with today. I like the idea with a console. I like the idea a lot. We don't have a console right now. We are recommending the MIDI controllers, the usage of other lighting consoles like Grandmas, Evolights, because we are supporting ArtNet in streaming SEN, in DMX, in MIDI, in a lot of possibilities to integrate Matrix into clubs. I like your question. I like it, but not today. Sorry about this one. Question 16. Omar Kurtu, does Aura give to Matrix software license for use 8 or 32 universes like Plexus? No, does not. So you need a Matrix key for the Aura 8. The Matrix 5 entry would be perfect. The entry key is 8 universes, very affordable key. Using one key, you can program unlimited amount of Aura devices. So you, as a Matrix partner or installer for architectural projects, if you own one key in your warehouse, you can program unlimited amount of Aura devices with one key. For the 32 universes, the Matrix 5 basic key would be perfect. Again, same situation here. You need one key to program unlimited amount of Aura devices to create the shows. Question 17, Nicolas, again, I have one Aura 32 master. How many Aura slaves can be connected to a network switch? Aura 32, again, you can daisy chain in the first row. So you can have 10 Aura 32s in a row. One as a master, 9 slaves. Then you go to a network switch and you're using a separate line. You can have one master and almost unlimited slaves. So it depends on the network traffic, of course. So if it also depends if you're using 10, 100 or gigabit network. It's not 100% clear to tell you a correct number today, but you can use a lot of slaves, that's for sure. Mm-hmm. So if you have one line of network cable, Sebastian just told me this, our recommendation would be 32 devices of Aura 32, the maximum amount on one single line. This would be our recommendation. So if you do the math, 32 is 1,000 universes. This would be the limit of a physical network for fluid animations for the 33 frames per second or even 50 frames per second for fluid animations. So 32 devices. Question 18. Is it possible to input, output audio using only the Aura? No, it's not. Yes and no. So the Aura is not a computer. It's a standalone device for architectural, mostly architectural environments. You can record any content from ArtNet or streaming SEN. So if you use Matrix software and you have music running in the background, so you see the equalizations in the equalizer effects, and you press record, you will see the equalizers also on the Aura, but these ones are not real equalizers, like the beautiful sound to light and music to light effects in Matrix. It's like a fake equalizer. So you could record an equalizer effect, yes, but it would not be reacting on the music because you have no audio jack on the Aura. There's no audio analyzer running. It's a SD card player, so you can play back huge amount of ArtNet and streaming SEN shows. Question 19, is the Aura RDM from Genome, is the Aura RDM compatible to get email notifications of sensors like temperature? No, it's not a RDM device like the devices you saw yesterday in my presentation. We had yesterday a presentation about Matrix Radar. Again, it's available on YouTube. If you look at this, you saw some lights behind me, and these devices are RDM-enabled devices. These devices you can monitor maintenance using radar technology. The Aura is not an RDM device, no. Question number 20 from New Vision Technology in Taiwan. Is it possible to use Nebula and Stellar or Luna at the same time with Aura? Very good questions, yes. And the answer is, of course, yes. You know us. If you use Matrix software, you can combine all the outputs like USB1, Stellar, Nebula, Luna, and the same situation here is also for the Aura. So you can output, because again, the Aura is outputting ArtNet and streaming SEN, you can connect a Stellar, a Nebula, a Luna, and output the amount of universes over all the devices. So you can decide this, yes. Question 21, Bardo Lighting Designer. If I have 33 universes in a show and Aura 32 connected, will Aura pop up any error if one universe cannot be recorded? No. So you connect the Aura, you will see all the universes in the device manager, like all the other devices you connect, like the Luna, like the Nebula. You see all the 32 universes. In the patch, you are setting up your lights. If you have 33 universes, the last universe will not be recorded to the Aura because the limitation is 33 universes. Question 22. If I purchase Aura, I don't have a Matrix license. How to program Aura without Matrix license? So if you want to output Matrix content to the Aura, you need the Matrix key to output the data. Again, for the Matrix Aura 8, Matrix 5 entry, for the Matrix Aura 32, you need a basic key. But you have also the option, you saw this, the live record from the website. So you can record any source to the Aura from any console, from any media server, just using the record button on the website. Question 23, Chintan Patel, hello to India. I hope you are safe and you are healthy. Can I program 128 universes in Aura if I have Matrix entry key? No, you can't. Entry key is 8 universes. That's the limitation of entry key. No, you can't. Question 24, Nicholas again. Can I trigger some scenes or change dimmer or speed with a DMX console? DMX console not, you are supporting ArtNet in, streaming ACN in, and remote HTTP in. So you can trigger the dimmer or the speed from a browser, from an ArtNet source, or from a ACN source. So if your console can output ArtNet, this would be the easiest part. Just output ArtNet, and you can trigger the Aura, brightness, speed, scenes, things like this. Question 25, again, New Vision Technology from Taiwan. For project that is running Aura, which is a playback device without a computer, does it mean that the customer don't need to buy a Matrix license key, correct? That's correct, CS, because you, as a lighting designer, you have the key. You are programming the shows for your clients. You can program this using your keys. When you send the Aura, including the SD cards, to your clients, the client can connect the power to the device and it runs without a computer, no Windows license, no headache, no administration, no Matrix key. Yes, it's working exactly in this way. Question 26 from Daniele. Is there the possibility to set the fade time between the scenes? Yes, you saw this at the website. In the scenes, you can change. By default, it's 2 seconds. You can change to 1 second, 5 seconds, whatever you want. Yes, it's possible. I see no more questions on my screen. By the way, thanks a lot, Tilo, from home. He's working from home. Thanks a lot, Franz. Both of them are reading the chat and helping me with the questions. I get the questions from Tilo and Franz, who are reading the chat and giving me the questions on my monitor. Thank you, guys. You're doing a good job. I don't see any questions anymore. So I see a lot of... One more question comes. Okay, we wait 1 more second. Not a problem. Okay, from Hugo Malian, how many Aura can I see and control via the graphical user interface at the same time? You see, if you connect the Auras in the device manager, you see all the Aura devices, all the universes. So if you connect 10, you will see 10. And you can, I showed this, you can use master and slave, so you can set up this is master, this is slave. You can connect all the devices to the device manager. You can activate the outputs, so you see all of them at the Matrix software. Another one from Badru, the lighting designers incoming. Is it possible to change from ArtNet to streaming ACN? To record from the Matrix software live, any settings in Matrix software? I don't understand the question. So in Matrix, you can output ArtNet or streaming ACN. You can decide this. So depending on the device you have connected in the network options in the Matrix software, you can activate streaming ACN. You can activate ArtNet. You can even output both of them at the same time. So you can output ArtNet, streaming ACN, and all the other protocols like DMX and DVI all at the same time. And I hope this answers your question. So you can output ArtNet, streaming ACN, and in the Aura, you set up, you want to record ArtNet or streaming ACN, and depending on the output, the Aura will record or will not record. There's another funny one, number 29 from Craig Singer. Hello to Sunrise, Florida. I hope the weather is nice today in Sunrise. I hope you are safe, you are healthy, Craig. Craig Singer is from Inner Circle Distribution. Inner Circle Distribution is our US exclusive distributor since many years. And the question from Craig Singer is, can we do a Medwix live stream every morning? Well, we could do this, Craig. We could do this. I'm always online on Skype. Just call me. We could do this every morning. If you place an order every morning, we could do this. You know, every order, every day, just an order placement, very easy. And I do a live stream every morning. Okay, no problem. Question 30 from Rajesh. I have another question. How can we control DC motors by Medwix? Very good question. I hope Sebastian can write down the question. This is a good question for tomorrow. Tomorrow we have 5.3 session, some news about Medwix 5.3, and also a Q&A session. I think the Q&A session will be very big, a lot of questions. This is a good question I can answer tomorrow. Yes, it is possible how to do this. You will see this very likely tomorrow. Question 31, Badru Lighting Design again. You can search ArtNet. Can you search ArtNet in Device Manager? Can you search Aura that can help how many Auras connected to Medwix? So yes, if you connect the Aura to the Device Manager, you see all the Aura devices in the Device Manager, all the devices, all the universes automatically. You can activate them. Do we want to show this, Sebastian? We can show it to the Device Manager. Yes, so all the Medwix hardware products, the Nebula, Stella, Luna range, all the Medwix products which are supporting ArtNet have a so-called pull reply package. When you connect the devices to a Medwix software and you click on search in the Device Manager, Medwix software will automatically detect all the connected devices, no matter if it's Aura, Nebula, Stella, you will see all the devices automatically, very easy to use in our case. Question 32, again from Daniele. Is there a possibility to change fade time between the scenes in live mode during playback a scene? Yes, also this is possible. So you can go in the Aura configuration on the website. You can change the parameters live. And if the Aura is changing to the next scene and you have already saved the fade time, the differences from maybe 2 seconds to 1 second, it will use the 1 second automatically. This is no problem. This works. No more questions. A lot of thank you messages. Again, if we are here to help and support you. You can reach us by email, by phone, by Skype, by a lot of options. My recommendation would be email. So if you are now watching the stream and maybe a few hours later you have some questions, just send us an email. The sales and support team are here to help you to answer the questions by email. Not a problem. For me, it's now time to say goodbye. Thank you guys for joining this live session again today. I see a lot of guys who are joining almost every day the live session. This means a lot to us. Thank you for your time. Thank you for joining this session. Please stay healthy and have fun with Medwix, of course. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you.
We'll be right back.